Hi there. My name is Mark Chen, and this is my co-host, Miaoui. Miaoui is going to tell you about this book, Photography, a 21st Century Practice, after she's finishing eating treat. Miaoui, are you going to say something? Well, I guess not. I'm going to do it myself. Hi, again, my name is Mark Chen, and I am going to tell you about this book written by myself and my friend Chelsea Shannon. In this video, I'm going to introduce this book to you chapter by chapter, and I'm going to show you how we wrote the book to make it live up to its name, which is A 21st Century Practice. Let me start off by showing you the cover photo. This piece by Laura Placement is titled In Response to Print of McWay Falls. It's such a great blend of modernism and tradition, and we thought it's very in line with the spirit of 21st century practice. That's why we choose this photo to represent the book. Taylor and Francis is the publisher, and the book is published under the brand of Focal Press and Routledge. You can find the link to the official website under the descriptions below. It is also available on Amazon in the format of paperback, hardcover, and e-textbook. 14 chapters. Chapter 1 is devices. It's an overview of today's option for equipment to capture images, starting from smartphone to mirrorless camera, which is poised to take over from DSLRs, to drone cameras. The discussion goes beyond the technical consideration to conceptual and traditional choices. Chapter 2 is optics. It is the physics behind photography. So why talking about science in a book about art? Is it important? The answer is a loud yes. Knowing how things work gives artists a firm control over their tools. And also it liberates artists, especially when the artist is facing the challenge of figuring out how to do things haven't been done before. Chapter 3, Exposures, talks about the technique to get the images correctly taken, but it doesn't stop there. It goes on to discuss the consideration of aesthetics and narratives supported by the technique. It is a chapter well balanced between principles and hands-ons. After 3 chapters of discussions on techniques, you may also call that the crafts of photography, we move on to the discussion of forms. So, chapter 4, composition. If photography were a visual language, then the composition can be considered its grammar. This chapter introduces composition elements, and through examples of successful images, it explains how each element becomes the basis of formal strategy. What is that? Formal strategy can be considered as the arrangement of shapes and colors that facilitate storytellings. Chapter 5 is light. Light to photography is like bodies to dancers, words to writers, or sounds to musicians. Now, this chapter explores the factors that decide the quality of light. For example, hard versus soft. Then he talks about how to manipulate the quality of light, either on available lighting or on artificial lighting. Then he shows how to practically set up a lighting studio, such as where I am now. So far, the book chapters have been on the topics about capturing images. In a digital workflow, eventually, the captured images have to be organized, adjusted, enhanced, or even composited. And that brings us to the next 2 chapters. Chapter 6 and Chapter 7 are Post-Production 1 and Post-Production 2. And these 2 chapters cover the two industrial standard tools, namely Lightroom and Photoshop. These two chapters are 100% hands-on. Procedures are illustrated in detail, and practice files are provided on our website at www.photo21c.com. In the age of Instagram, the following chapter, which is Chapter 8, Prints, is particularly important because making print is the only way to convert a virtual image into its physical, tangible form. It's also the major way to sell them. So making print shouldn't become a lost art. This chapter carries the torch of chemical photography, which is making test strips in the darkrooms. Now we do it digitally through the inkjet printers. We now shift gears to Chapter 9, Content and Concept. Content is about message, narrative, or even activism. It is art serving purposes beyond art. Concept is about the idea or thoughts that fundamentally changes the creative processes or the product it produces. So here we are at Chapter 9.5, Craft, Composition, Content, and Concept. The four C's. The four C's are the four venues of an artist's creativity, also the four directions for an artist to invest his or her effort on, also the four ways to appreciate another artist's work. So the four C's helped both on the creative end, also on the receiving end of art. Halfway into the book, this short yet important chapter concludes the previous chapters into the fundamental framework of photographic art. Now that we have plenty of discussions on the questions of what, let's talk about the questions of how. In Chapter 10, Development and Presentation, we answer the question of how first by showing you how to work as an artist. For example, how to develop a project. And then we show you how to show your work. For example, how to work with galleries. Now, if these tasks sound expensive to you, you're right. That is why it is very important to talk about money, which is the topic of Chapter 10.5. Another short chapter that is very important, but most people are too afraid to ask. This chapter talks about the ways and means to make an artist's career sustainable. Now we look back and see how we do things in the past shape how we do things today. In Chapter 11, Tradition, we'll examine how some of the most experimental and avant-garde artists base their work on traditions. Add a dimension of time to photography and you get video. And video is a topic of Chapter 12. In this chapter, we give you a brief history of video art, which is rooted in performance art, and also how today video has become the most natural next medium for a photographer to cross over to. Chapter 13 is Computational Photography. Now, this title might sound a bit unusual to you, but it really shouldn't be, because you see, digital photography is based on numerical data, and numerical data can be computed for various purposes. For example, photo merging, stitching images together to produce, say, a panorama, or photo merging to increase the dynamic range, we call that high dynamic range imaging, or HDR, or even 3D modeling, which is covered in an example in this chapter in great details. Finally, we have Chapter 14, Words. They say a picture is worth 1,000 words, which is true. But adding another few hundred words to that picture, and the picture might be worth even more. And that is the power of artist statement. Now, this chapter offers a systematic approach to break down your work and put it back together in words to form a most comprehensive artist statement. Miaowei, are you coming? Are you coming to join me before the video finishes? I guess not. I do hope you find this video helpful in introducing to you Photography, a 21st Century Practice, and I hope you find this book a new and sharp tool in your classrooms in helping you to teach and to learn photography. See you next time. In this video, I'm going to give you an introduction to this book, chapter by chapter. But first, let me start off by... Miaowei. Don't do that.